Hello, my name is Hantayumi. I am a cyborg. Welcome to the Gizverse podcast. The show dedicated to the King Wizard and the Lizard Wizard universe.
Yo, man, hot take. I honestly think that album is the best album that they've come out with.
We need more cookie.
A multi-dimensional universe with an invisible face.
Welcome to an altered future, brother.
Once created by a band, is now sustained by its fans.
Uh-oh. I hear the road train a-coming, baby. It's a-coming.
Open the door to your mind, pause. Here are your hosts, Tommy O'Neill and Brian
Sintron.
Get strong, Brian.
Hi, world.
Get strong, bro. Just gonna slip it in.
Don't be saying that too much, though, man. Don't be saying that too much, dude. People hear it, man. Listen, easy with that, you know?
Whoa. If you're thieving from us, if you're listening to this and you're not one of us and you're thieving from us,
whoa.
That's some fucked up shit, bro. I'm not going to
bottom of the barrel.
Bottom of the barrel. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Gizverse podcast. My name's Tommy. You know that's Brian sitting over there.
Yeah.
Kicking it, flipping it, ripping it. Missed you guys. We've been trying to set up some different styles of podcasts lately, and I'm just going to flat out say it. It's not working out. I don't know what that means, but we've been trying to get people on the podcast. But that seat over there, I have like a different... You can't see it. The camera angle is not. Yeah, I know, Brian. Brian, you can see it a little bit. Yeah, you can look through the camera.
I see it a little bit.
It's kind of like over there. There's a different seat right here that we could have guests on the show and talk about King Gizzard. We've been trying to get people on, dude. It's very difficult. I'm not gonna lie. Even on Skype and stuff like that. Schedules, I guess that's an excuse. But 10-minute phone call? You can't make a 10-minute phone call.
Come on.
You talk to your mom anymore? Just stop talking to your mom for 1 week and talk to us. That's not that big of a deal.
No problem. I don't see what the issue is. It's about King Gizzard. You talk to your mom about King Gizzard? Maybe you probably do. I do.
That makes it sound like we're hungry, but we're not that hungry. I gotta be honest. I thought that this was more of a complaint from the folks. You know what I mean? Because we'd go to places and people were like, "Hey, man." What's up, bro? Why am I not on the effing podcast? It's like, all right. I mean,
jump in, man. You know,
I don't know. My bad, dude. Message us. So if you do want to be on the podcast and you seriously want to be on the podcast, message us. We will set up a date and time and record a little 10-minute interview with you about, we'll have like some pre-questions that we'll send your way. It won't be super live. So if you say something you don't want to say, we can edit it out or something like that. So don't be too nervous. It's nothing like that. It's going to be like an hour long. No nerves. I've sensed a little bit of that. Maybe a little nervousness, but don't worry about it. And we're
cool guys.
We're,
man,
super neat guys.
And very cool.
I will say this, at the meetups, at one meetup in particular, probably for sure, but probably multiple meetups, what we're going to do is we're going to bust out a camera, maybe some audio equipment on top of that. Definitely going to need some audio equipment. We're going to be walking around talking to people who want to be on camera. We're not going to force you to talk, but if you want to be on, we're going to interview people that way too. So it'll be a little easier way. And I think we're going to get into that a little bit more later on. Just up the top. And
yes, we are.
I will say, Brian, we should talk about Silver Cord a little bit today. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Because we labeled the other one part one. For us to not have a little smidgen of a part two is blasphemous. So
we'll call this part 1.2.
1.2. Our intention, I mean? Yeah, but Brian texted me something. I'll tell you what he texted me in a little bit. But the other day, this last couple of weeks, we wanted to have people do interviews and kind of compile it, and we would talk about it on the podcast and then have other people on the show to talk about it on the podcast. At a certain point, we do have to kind of move on from a topic, and Brian texted me that the other day. He's like, bro, I'm a little done with this album at this point. I think most people are kind of done with this album at this point in terms of thinking about it in the new, in the now. So, and I have to agree with Brian. So, if we don't set up these episodes quickly, I think we're going to move on from the album. And maybe that's our bad. Maybe we're not as thrilled about this album in particular. Maybe if we were, we would do more or seek more about it. But
Yes.
What do you think about that?
I think we're both on that same ground. I will say, like, that doesn't close the door on it by any means. So, I mean, there's still, and we've talked about this before too, there's albums that we love and have reviewed in the past that wouldn't mind running back. You know, because now, I mean, you know, you put 2, 3, 7, 8 years in between them, and I think there's some we could definitely revisit and some we still haven't hit. So, like, it's for me personally, it sounds funny right now harping too much on an album that we weren't huge fans of. You know what I mean? So, which you can make the argument that maybe that means we should get deeper and really express why, but no, we're happy boys. We love King Gizzard, man. So we want to progress a little bit, but
right,
you brought up talking about it a little bit, and yeah, I will say, man, because I know it's coming up. I think, even though I don't know, I guess I really have no idea how much of Silvercord they will play live. Nobody does. I don't think the band knows at this very moment either. I was listening the other day, some extended versions, some not extended versions. There's a couple songs I wouldn't mind seeing live on there. I think they'll make them, as long as it's, in my opinion, if it's not 18 a minute jam of Thaya or the Silvercord title track, I'd probably do without that. But I think just reading the lyrics off Silvercord, man, Joey's really going in on some of those, man. And if they can translate, and obviously live performance more than just lyrics, but if they can translate some of those sounds and stuff live, it could be pretty cool, man. I don't want to see the whole live album in extended versions all around or whatever, but I think a couple of them could be set up really nicely, in my opinion, particularly Thaya and the Silvercord. Gilgamesh could be tight too, though. I don't know, man. I'm with Gizzard, I'm leaving them a blank canvas always. I want them to do what makes them happy and what's fun and what they think we like. So full control to the boys, of course, but I think a couple of those songs could sound pretty cool, man. Have you found one that you would be particularly inclined more than the rest to see live?
I think it's called, I already forgot the name. I'm sorry. It's not my favorite album.
I'll be bad with names sometimes too. I mean, just be like that.
Yeah. The Egyptian God one, Set. Set is probably my tune on that. And that, unfortunately, means I got to listen to Ambrose rap a little bit. I'm sorry. If anybody over there has heard this, I'm not trying. I listened to a little bit of me complaining about the white guy rap. But I got to be honest. I heard Ari Spears, who's a comedian who does like rap. He was on Mad TV and a ton of other stuff. But he does like
Jay-Z impression,
rap impressions. Yeah.
A lot
he
of
does,
good
like,
impressions.
Hip-hop
yeah.
impressions. And I heard, dude, he said something that I was dying laughing. And I've never heard anybody else say this, except I've complained about it to Brian before, so he might smile a little bit. He was talking about English rappers, and he's like, dude, he's like, I can't stand that shit. I told you this, Brad. I was like, I can't, dude. I can't stand it. Oh, Bumba Clot and me and the Weasel Bops and me go flipping flops and the dippity dops. Dude, what are you saying right now? What are you fucking crazy? That sounds so, so stupid. And I don't care race, creed. It doesn't matter. That has nothing. It is an American culture thing. So to hear any other country do it, it sounds weird to my ears. It just, I think that is more what my thing is. Yes, the white boy hip hop element of it. Sure. I've gotten over that over the years, though. I think for me, it's more of, it sounds European hip hop ish, you know what I mean? So, which
True.
I guess is
yeah, yeah.
kind of the fucking point of the album almost. It's like a European hip hop album, you know what I mean?
European hip hop album.
Is it an, would you say it's an Australian hip hop album? What are you saying?
I can put no nationality or creed to the Silvercord. I will say
Check it out.
It's definitely got that, like, you know, East Berlin or whatever, you know, 1989.
East Berlin.
Yo, like, they're, like, in, like, a factory. And there's, like, 100,000, 40 people there.
Just sweating.
But sweating. And then boom, boom, boom. So, like, and I know, like, I mean, I think Joey likes that shit. His like, bullying stuff
Duh.
Is that.
No,
it's very,
for sure.
Like,
look at that mustache, bro. He definitely likes it.
Look at that guy parties, man. You know, he's had a little white powder in that mustache before. You know what I mean?
For sure.
Who hasn't? You know?
Who hasn't?
So respect. I think I don't disagree with you on that. You're right. Set. I could see them, especially if they're like mixing it into stuff. Set like a, yeah, that could be fun. It could definitely get the crowd grooving. And I think, listen, man. I think this coming year, we'll see some interesting King Gizzard sets, man. I think, you know, especially for example, Austin, where we're having a meetup, we're talking about it. Don't worry about it. No big deal. That 3-hour marathon set, I think they're going to throw us a lot of stuff, man. I think, of course, we're going to get an hour, probably an hour and a half of just Petro, mixing it with Rat's Nest, and it's just like them going heavy. There's gonna be some craziness, but I think that we're also gonna get an hour of just like this Butterfly 3000-y, Silver Quarry kind of stuff. That
you think they're gonna play Butterfly?
It's gonna be a vibe, man.
You think they're gonna play Butterfly 3000?
I have no other option but to demand it. Let me put it this way, man. I've said on the podcast, if they can play Silver Chord live, they can give us Interior People live. They can give us Catching Smoke live. Don't tell me you can play that other electronic stuff and not pull out some Butterfly 3K stuff. That's all I got to say about that, man.
Now, Interior People's probably the one that I want to hear the most. That's if I was going to point to a song, that was it. What Butterfly song do you want to hear the most?
It's probably that one. Blue Morpho could be really cool. Ooh, actually. That may be real tight. I'm sorry. Hold on. Blue Morpho would be cool. It's either, for me, Interior People or... Oh, my God. I just went totally blank. Catching Smoke. Catching Smoke would be bananas.
Catching
and I think they
smoke.
Could turn that into a whole circus up there.
Yeah.
And, you know, the crowd's going to be lying the doobies. The crowd will be just jumping, really excited and surprised to hear it. Because those songs always hit. When it's like a surprise, that's so fucking tight, you know? So I think that could be really fun. Again, in that world, if they give us like an hour of a more electronic feel, I think they could do some really fun stuff. Or sure, maybe we're not super sold on Silver Chord right now, but then you might see a couple songs live and be like, damn, dude, that was a really fun part of that set. Slay the Mighty set,
yeah.
Perhaps, you know?
I don't disagree with you at all. I think it could potentially be a cool album live. There have been so many times where I think King Gizzard doesn't show on the album how powerful the song is. A lot of times the song can sound lighter on, and I don't know what other, I guess heavier would be the adverse of that, but that's what I mean. Like, the song feels bassier and hits you in your chest. The kick drum, it needs, sometimes it's intentional. You know, the sound is a lo-fi type of deal, so.
Right.
Live, that lo-fi shit, you can put some effects on it, but you can't put effect. I guess you can on a kick drum, but they don't. That shit's like doom, 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 and it punches you in your chest, baby. So that sounds a lot different live. And if they're playing a kit, which I hope they do, like a hybrid electronic kit set type deal, I think that would be really interesting to hear live. Personally, I think that would be...
I agree.
Maybe my favorite way to listen to it live and... Not in a setting with headphones or even in the car. So I've done the car treatment. I've done the phone treatment. Mm-hmm. I've done the earphones treatment, trying to give it the whole gambit here. And, I say live is probably the last venture that I have to go on to listen to it to give my full opinion about the album. So I'll be waiting to hear it this upcoming tour. I'm excited. I know you are, Therese, so... speaking of this upcoming tour, we did announce recently about the meetup. You want to give us some information about that, Brian? I think we picked the venue. It's Meanwhile. We got hit up by
Meanwhile Brew House.
Quite a
few
people recommended this spot, and we got hit up by a very sweet gentleman that works there. And yeah, I think that's gonna be the spot, Brian. Right?
Yeah, man. Generally, really excited about this. Like, of course, you know, you have nerves floating around because it's still 10 months away. There's a lot of moving parts.
Right.
All understandable. You know what I mean? So there's a lot that goes mixed up with it. But, man, I see nothing but really cool things, man. Like you just mentioned, our good buddy Ryan reached out. He was the first one to reach out, like, hey, do it here. This would be a good idea. Send us, like, information on the place, which if you were at, you know, Red Rocks 2022, we were at the Monkey Barrel. That was an amazing time. The turnout was crazy. The venue was really cool. It could have been larger. That was a big turnout. This venue, Meanwhile Brewing, is completely built for a big old hootenanny. They have a stage too, man. We're talking about potentially having some live bands play. I recommend it maybe a little after the meetup to keep people around, keep people boozing, having a good time. But Ryan is really excited about it. Myself, T-Bone, we're super stoked about it. I think we're going to do some really cool things here, man. We're talking about, this is, you know, a little secret or whatever. Maybe a little special brew being made for this event, a little King Gizzard themed brew, but that's, you know, you didn't hear that from me. You didn't hear that. Don't even worry about it. No problem. Tommy and I got some really cool little teas that are cooking up in the mix right now that will absolutely be available there. I think it's going to be cool, man. I think it's going to be damn cool. talking about setting up cool lighting and all sorts of stuff, man. Super inclusive. Come bring your homies. Going to be a good old time. Yeah, kid-friendly also. It doesn't have to be 21 and up as well. You can come in as a young folk as well. So, good luck,
young
but,
folk.
You know.
Young folk. Don't young bring folk. Your kids to this shit. Don't do that.
I wouldn't recommend
if you have a baby or something like that, look, there's some guys that I've seen, you can pull that off or whatever, but this might be a little rowdy-dowdy. We don't know. It might be a little hootenanny-ish. So just be wearisome of that, and I don't...
Beers are going to be flowing.
Beers are going to be flowing, but be on the beers. It's just a lot of people. So you just want to be careful in that situation, bringing little chitlins all the way around. I don't know if I'm recommending that, okay? So maybe, like, you know, 18 or whatever. And we also don't know the rules of this place. Maybe they don't allow folks underage to be there. Maybe they do. I don't know yet. But we'll release all that information. We'll have flyers coming up available. We like to produce many flyers, and we like to put the information out there in many different ways. So you'll see clips of the podcast on promoting it as well. But we have other shirts that you've seen us do before that we're going to be bringing as well. And we're going to have, like Brian said, at least two new shirts. We're going to have some wristbands available. We're always going to have some stickers on deck. And probably some other stuff. And it's not the cool part about this is it's not just us. If you've never been to a meetup before, this is pretty much what goes down. It's not just us setting up. It's a ton of other creators and other people that have been inspired by King Gizzard to create stuff. I guess that's the best word. And so I'm going to use it again. And we just like kind of post up. It's like a King Gizzard flea market a little bit. And you come out and just walk around, talk to people that are also interested in King Gizzard. A lot of people are selling merch. Some people are giving stuff away for free. It's a really cool environment. Like Brian said, there may or may not be a beer that's created, a King Gizzard themed beer. We don't know. We'll see. And the Austin meetup is going to be the big shebang for right now. We do have maybe two other meetups in the works, at least a meetup and then a half a meetup. Because I'll do at least a half one here in Colorado. We'll pull something off. I know Brian's going to have a hard time getting work off. But I know if I coordinate with other people, I can kind of pull something off. And we can get maybe a miniature meetup. Because it's a lot of work. That's all. That's the only reason I'm saying a miniature meetup. But in Miami, I'll probably be there for that one. So we'll do another meetup in Miami. So I don't want to confuse you guys right now. But Austin and Miami are two definite meetups that are going on. We're going to release information about the Miami meetup more. Austin, we have all the information that we have right now. We're going to give away on the Instagram. So if you do have questions, either feel free to message us on the Instagram, follow us at Gizverse Podcast, and you can just look at the comment section too. That's also a really easy way. You can just click on it and it'll send you the link or whatever crap. And basically, all the information is going to be available on there. That's your best bet. And if you have any additional questions, you can either just like wait a couple days and we'll release that information because we haven't gotten the info yet, or you can message us and we'll get with you. If you're a vendor wanting to, I'm sorry if this is a little boring, but this is kind of important stuff. Semi-important to some people. I don't know. Maybe it's not important to anybody. Who knows? It's not like cancer. It's not cancer level important, but it's, you know, it's semi-important. You get what I'm trying to say.
It's Gizzard.
It's
important.
Gizzard.
Come on,
it's Gizzard level important. Get strong, bro. So the main thing, if you're a vendor, sorry, my brain goes over. If you're a vendor, just message us, and the main reason we want you to message us is, one, we want to control every aspect of this. it's because we want to make sure you have a table available, and if we have too many vendors, we want to tell people ahead of time, like, hey, you can still come and set up your stuff, but maybe if you could work together with another vendor, and you guys can maybe share a table or something like that, and we can coordinate with people, and then rides is always an issue, and then sometimes tickets are an issue. If people are looking for last minute tickets or something like that, and maybe somebody bailed and they have a friend, there's a lot of little sub group chats and stuff like that we have going on, and we can point you in the right direction. So don't be afraid to hit us up and message us, and we can kind of point you in the right place to be at. Additionally, if you want to be on the show to talk about your vending and any stuff that you're wanting to bring to the table to the meetup. Like Brian said, super inclusive. The only people that aren't welcome are absolute dickheads that just want to be assholes, and that's for obvious reasons. You know what I mean?
Keep them at home. But and if those are your kids, keep them at home too.
We don't see very many of those. But we're
We don't. Luckily,
we're excited. This is going to be a good one. I don't know if we're going to do a live podcast yet. That sounds. Last time it was tough because the room was so narrow and there were so many damn people, and then like people were coming in, funneling out. It was a mess. There wasn't like a.
It was cool though.
It was cool. There just wasn't a stage. This time there is a stage, and if there's bands and stuff like that, it might be fun to go up there and talk and do some stuff. But who knows? Who knows? Some of this stuff is still up in the air. We will release those pieces of information, but the main thing to keep in mind is it's going to be a blast, and we're definitely going to have as many people and as many vendors as humanly possible to smash into the event. And yeah, anything else you want to add to the Austin meeting, Brian? And then we can talk about the Miami one just a smidge.
Yeah, you mentioned vendors hitting us up. Please do that sooner than later, just so we have you locked in, ready to rock. Tell me what you're bringing, that kind of good stuff. And we confirm with the venue. They have X amount of tables. I don't know what X is, so... Please keep us posted. We'll figure it out for you. Again, if you haven't, I mean, a couple of people commented on Facebook, which was nice, and they said, wow, this is going to be my first Gizzard meetup. I can't wait to meet you, like, Gizzy people all around. It's like, it's nice, man. Sometimes at a Giz show, at a Giz show, your main concern is them performing. So you're like, you know, while you're, like, talking to people around you and having a nice time, it's not, like, the main focus of the event, right? The event is the band. So this is a really nice way, especially if you live in Austin, just to meet other, like, wow, I didn't know this many people in our city listen to King Gizzard. So it's just really nice chance to meet a lot of friends, get a lot of really cool goodies that like might only be exclusively sold there or like given away there and stuff. You support a local Austin venue. It's going to be a really good time, man. Everybody's coming with the best of intentions, best of vibes. We're going to have a blast.
And that's a great point because there's a lot of times you go to a concert and you feel like, you know, maybe you don't have a lot of friends in town or you just moved to a new spot and you go to your King Gizzard show and you're like, man, I don't feel like I know anybody here. Hey, man, if you want to just go and chit-chat with people, there is no social pressure here. Zero social pressure. I've been talked to by, and I mean, I'm a little used to that. People, I like to talk to people who like to talk to me. It's a cool thing. I'm down with the clowns. But if especially the Insane Clown Posse, that's my other band that I like. I got another podcast called the Insane Clown Posse Podcast.
Fire.
Wow, I got a lot of interest. And then I'm shitting on white boy hip hop. Get the fuck out of here, bro. I'm just kidding. So yeah, if you're it's really inclusive, really cool people. I can't express that enough. I mean, it is not a weird environment whatsoever. Everybody's really chill and super nice.
It's a party, baby.
Yeah.
It is a whole party. And we're going to have a good time.
It's relaxing because me and Brian are in charge, and that's always nice. We're a little crazy because we'll be a little hectic, you know, trying to make sure all the T's and I's are dotted and whatnot. And
where's my beer?
But you guys can relax and have a good time because we're going to make sure everything is squared away way ahead of time and everything's nice and organized, and the venue's really great so far, and Ryan's been really great so far, so it's going to be a good time.
Killer.
And I think it's could be the best meetup so far, but that being said, I think it's going to be just as good as the Miami meetup. I got to be honest, that Miami meetup sounds sick, and we can't say 100% of everything and reasons why it's going to be sick, but trust me, it's going to be off the fucking chain. The weather is going to be a little different. The environment's going to be a little different. Miami's a lot different of a place than Austin. No offense, Austin. No offense. You know what I mean? I'm not shitting on anybody, but Miami's just a fucking vibe, bro. So Austin's Austin's a vibe, too. It's just two different vibes, man. So I do think they could be great little meetups for two different reasons. We don't have a venue for Miami, Brian and Tommy style. We're still working out some details before we decide that because basically – there's some major issues at hand that we want to get some stuff taken care of ahead of time so that way everything else falls into place, if that makes sense. But the Miami meetup is going to be a fucking thing.
It's going to be tight, man. I have my concerns at the moment, but it's going to be a good old time.
What are your concerns? Can you talk about them on the air or do we have to talk about them off the air?
Yeah, I can. I'll make this brief because it's more like a you and me conversation than anything else, but St. Augustine is the day before, right? Amazing. So St. Augustine, you know this more than most listen to the podcast probably. St. Augustine to Miami is about 4.5 hours, okay? And so it's the day before. So we wouldn't have the luxury of doing the meetup the day before a King Gizzard show. It would be day of, which is, you know, has its pros and cons.
And is that because you're going to St. Augustine show?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Of course. So, trickier, because that means we got to leave Matt early. We got to get to a venue, like, to do it, like, noon. Do, like, an early one kind of thing. If I mean, I don't know what time doors are for that show in Miami, but, yeah. So, those are again, that's more of a me and you convo. But
sounds like it's a you combo.
Just a couple hurdles.
I just want to let you know, the camera's just on you right now. It's not on me. So, the heat is on. I think this is a more of a you conversation, Brian. I think you need to pony up, get ready. You're going to drive a lot, okay? You're going to have to go.
A lot from, okay, is the whole thing.
That's what happens. It's one day a year, okay? This is
no, stop it. Tom, do not, no.
It's not every day.
Absolutely not.
No, no, no. Where are you going to do this?
We're driving. No, no, no.
We're going to do this in front of everybody,
Austin.
Brian. I'm singing this shit.
Listen, we're doing this right here, man. Turn this up. You listen, turn this up. Driving from Austin to Houston, from Houston to New Orleans to Atlanta, Atlanta.
None of those are meetups.
St. Augustine.
None of those are meetups. None of those are meetups.
What does that mean?
You know what that means.
What does that mean?
You know what that means. Meetups are legendary things that happen before a show. Are you telling these fans that want to go to the Austin meetup that meetups aren't important, Brian? Is that what you're doing right
They're
now?
They're huge. Support your local meetup,
okay,
no question
guys,
about it.
Do you see what I'm doing to Brian? This is how you get him. You got to get him in a corner, and you just keep wiggling around left and right, and he's gonna get it. He's going to settle down. You got to get him. You got to trap him. You got to trap him. We're going to do the Miami meetup, guys. Don't you worry. If we got to fucking put Brian in a sleeping bag and drive his ass down there ourselves, we're going to get him down there, and we're going to figure it out.
Hello.
Right? And I can't Gizzard. Tell you why it's going to be an important meetup, but it is going to be an important meetup. Well, would you rather
it's
do the,
good,
a Jacksonville meetup? Or a not Jacksonville meetup, a St. Augustine meetup?
Because
I think that would be harder to pull off because of the it's like a smaller place. Fewer places to park and shit. Miami's more, you know, it's easier to park.
Miami's more open.
More
for
open.
Sure. It's, you know, well, Miami's probably the one. Miami's probably the one, but we're going to win it. You wanna. Also, the chance of them adding a second Miami show, very much possible.
Okay.
So we're going to throw them in the mix too. There's a lot of stuff cooking, man.
Well,
a lot of stuff
also,
cooking,
you know? I mean, I can hold down the fort until you get down there. You know what I'm saying? So that's also something because I most likely won't be going to this St. Augustine one. That just seems silly for me.
Heard.
So I'll probably be able to go down to Miami a day in advance, and I could
Very
set
cool.
some stuff up down there and be a little more on top of it. I do have a couple kilos to flip while I'm chilling down there with my homies. But
it's a business trip.
Little side business trip. Comedian arrested for selling cocaine. It's not mine, you bitch. It's not mine.
It's not you, bitch.
I love calling newscasters bitch. I love when people, criminals, like just yelling bitch at the newscaster like it's their fault, like they did something wrong. Like, dude, they're literally just doing their job. Get out of my way, you bitch. Like, it's fucking, they're criminals. I love it. It's my favorite.
It's a criminal, man.
You did it. So, yeah,
guys,
either way, we'll figure it out, Brian. I just stop thinking about the future begrudgingly. I do that, too. I think about it. I'm like, I get nauseous with obligation. I'm like, ooh, I don't like it. I don't want to have
ooh,
anything.
Ooh.
I don't want to do anything. I just want to sit around and stare. That would be great. But
that sounds chill.
Unfortunately, I definitely think the Miami, it'll happen. Don't worry about it. We'll do it.
It's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
It's absolutely going
to
happen.
But I definitely
sure.
agree with you. It would be very nice if they added another show. That would be very convenient for us to do it.
Agreed.
To give us a day buffer would be very nice. But I will say, because initially I thought you were worried about people that were going to St. Augustine not being able to make the meetup in Miami. And I was like, I don't think that's going to happen, bro. Okay. Yeah. And then I picked up on what you're saying. It was going to be a hassle for you to drive down there and shit. So, yes.
Yeah, no, it'll be fine. People are going to pull up. It'll be a good time. There's also, you know, listen, man, there's a lot of meetups going on right now. Follow at, like, weirdoswarm.org. They got a really nice little page right now of depicting who's doing a meetup. Bro, they're out there, bro. There's a lot cooking up, man.
Right.
So, like, support your local meetup. Gizverse Podcast, we're going to be doing our thing. And, listen, man, like I said, Houston, New Orleans, I might pull up to some of those, you know, with a gang of T-shirts and just like, yo. What's up, baby boys? You know what I mean? So it's going to be a party, you guys. It's going to be a whole lot of party. You're going to see a lot of us. We're going to see a lot of you guys. I'm excited, man.
That
I'm
sounded
excited.
Like Brian trying to get out of the Miami meetup. That is not what just happened right there, guys. Miami meetup's
no, the
going
Miami's
down.
Happening, dude.
He's just gonna he's gonna be everywhere. Don't worry about it. So
you'll see a lot of me, man.
I'll be there when Brian needs someone to carry the load. I'll be there, bro.
That'll be inebriated.
I'll fucking inebriatedly be there. Okay, drunk, in a bikini bra. Okay, mind your goddamn business. If I'm wearing a coconut bra, figure it out for yourself. I'm a man.
Eyes up here, mister.
I'm a man. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that.
I'm a man.
So we'll be releasing information more about the Miami show. Hopefully King Gizzard decides to hashtag put another show on. But I gotta be honest, that's really greedy of us because it is at the end of their tour, and it's like,
for sure.
Boy, you know, they do bring their family on the road with them. So come on, guys, do another one, you pussies. You could go to Disneyland. Let's be real.
And yeah, you think their family doesn't want to hang out at Miami Beach for a day or two, hit up South Miami, Beach, enjoy
and
the vibe.
The extra
Mojito.
Show will pay for everybody to go to Disney World, get VIP passes and shit like that. Go to Disney, bro. Disney's the shit. Florida Disney.
And they can play a show here in Orlando.
Florida Disney is the shit. Japan Disney is also the shit. Japan Universal is also the shit. But Orlando Universal and Orlando Disney, that's the shit.
Fire.
That's the best one in America. Hands down, no questions asked. So listen, you Australian bastards. You put on another goddamn show.
And have a blast.
And you have
city.
A blast, goddammit. We'll release more information as it comes out. We'll be releasing more flyers, but if you need direct information, go to our bio. Definitely follow us on Instagram because that is the source of most, if not all, the information that we have. We're trying to release on the daily. Clips, all that other shit. Follow on Spotify. You guys are doing great. I don't know what the fuck happened, but everybody decided to follow us on Spotify and change platforms. Super appreciate it. That helped us out on Spotify a ton. So keep doing that. Keep hitting that follow button. That really helps us out a lot. And if you guys want to be on the show, hit us up. If you have any questions about the venue, the meetup, if you're a vendor, hit us up. Do all that stuff. Feel free to interact with us. We're always available. It might take us a couple days to get back to us. We do have our own shit going on outside of this podcast, but we'll get back to you ASAP. Brian, anything else you wanted to throw out there, baby?
Yes, if you happen to live in Miami and know of a really cool spot, that this kind of word of mouth, especially when we're not on, you know, on
the ground floor,
on the streets, you know what I mean? Exactly. This kind of stuff really helps out if you know like a really cool venue that you know or connected with, or just like, yo, this would be a cool spot. Think about it. Shoot us a message. That's nice to know.
I know a couple comics too. I can ask that question too, and see if I can get some venues because the venues that we are looking for are a little bit bigger. We, like Brian said, the first or the second meetup that we had, it was insane, and we need to make sure the facility can fit all that. So if you have any ideas or if you know people on the ground floor, hit us up, man. We're always down to interact. So
yes, indeed.
Thanks a lot for listening, guys, and thanks a lot for following on the podcast. You guys are fucking awesome. We'll talk to you soon, and hopefully we'll see you soon at those meetups.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys. Have a good one.